Clip.
I'm leaving, Mr. Burrell.
Wait a minute! I said, wait a minute! You're not going anywhere until you and I come to an agreement.
What?
Are you trying to tell me my money's not good enough for you? I find that a little hard to swallow, you jockass!
Myself back there, stuffed that check down Burrell's throat. That's the bad guy in the movie. It kind of reminded me of the Million Dollar Man. And when I think about the Million Dollar Man, it kind of reminded me of some of these late night talk show hosts, you know, like that Pat Pajek, who spun the Wheel of Fortune and got lucky enough to get on TV. And then that brings me to David Letterman, man, who shouldn't even be around. And then everybody knows about Johnny C, the godfather of late night TV. But if you want to get real heavy, and if you want to get down to the basics, the man that's got the talent, the man that's got the charisma, the man that's going to be around for a long, long time, this is the heavyweight brother of late night TV. It's true, brother. It's true. And you know it. You're hot, and you know you're hot.
I'm just kind of trying
it's true.
Do the
everybody knows it.
Oh, boy.
What you got to say now?
What can I say, man?
The truth hurts, doesn't it?
You know what? I look at you. Do you know your arm is the size of my leg?
It's just...
Look at this. Look at this, man. Look at you. Look at that.
Close.
That's amazing. That's like Whitney Houston's waist. Boy, oh boy. How's it being a movie star again?
Well, it's been a long time. You know, I did Rocky III, and the whole world saw me take Sylvester Stallone and throw him out to his grandmother about 10 rows out. And it's been a while. We waited for the right vehicle because wrestling's been so good.
Yeah.
And with all the training, the prayers, and the vitamins, I had to worry about all the little Hulksters, man. And when, I'm out of breath from posing. When the No Holds Barred came up, it was a perfect vehicle to spread the word, you know, a little bit better. Action, adventure, entertainment, and I'm not standing there with a bunch of machine guns with 1,000 dead bodies at my feet. It's real squeaky clean for all the little Hulksters.
Yeah. That's good.
Yeah. Are you going to go see it?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, I gotta check it out. I gotta, cause see, I hear you do a love scene in it.
Ooh.
Tell me about that.
Well, I tell you, you know, you're gonna see a whole new Hulk Hogan in this movie. I do a lot of screaming and yelling to get the message across to all those kids out there. But in No Holds Barred, you're gonna see a brand new Hulk Hogan. You're gonna see me kind of vulnerable, real sensitive. And romantically, I almost get hooked by that beautiful lady, Joan Severance.
Yeah. Yeah.
Almost. There's a little nibbling. That's about it.
Okay, that's cool. That's cool. Now, I watched the Saturday Night Main Event. And first of all, tell me about this Zeus character.
He's trying to get me mad. Well, this Zeus dude, let me tell you about Zeus, brother. This Zeus dude, he's the bad guy in the movie No Holds Barred. I had trouble with him before the film, and man, when we got into production, I had a hard time with him. And now we're promoting the movie, and we put him on the WWF, on our superstar station, man, our superstars challenge shows. And Zeus, he's starting to believe his own publicity. We're giving him all this exposure. We're trying to make him a superstar, but he actually thinks he can beat Hulk Hogan, brother. And if Zeus, if you want a taste of reality, and if you want to feel what the largest arms in the world feel like around your neck, just come on down to my home, the Squared Circle. Zeus is awesome, man. Check him out. He's awesome.
He kind of gave you a hard time on the program the other night.
Yeah, I went out to the steel cage match to take care of business with a big boss man, and there was Zeus. He was standing there, and I thought he was just acting, but when he kicked me in the chops, brother, I knew he was for real.
Yeah.
I'm going to get him. Don't worry. If you come see my movie, No Holds Barred, you're going to see how I handle Zeus.
Yeah. Wow. Let's take a commercial. We'll come right back. I got a lot of stuff to ask.
I'm ready.
Let's talk about Macho Man Randy Savage. Yes. Are you all ever going to make up and get back? You all were a great team together, you know, and now you're feuding.
You know, the Macho Man, he was cool, man, because he was one heck of a role model for a while. But the thing is, it was basically a lack of communication. The thing with Elizabeth, she was so much in love with the Macho Man, mm-hmm. and the Macho Man was so much in love with Elizabeth. I was his partner, and every time I'd make a good move, she'd applaud. Every time I'd win a match, the Macho Man was getting a little jealous, you know. And with a lack of communication, the Macho Man put me right in the middle of this thing. And once he backed me up, dudes, I had to fight for my life. And that's what happened in WrestleMania 5. The Macho Man backed me in a corner, and I wiped him out.
Yeah.
You know, he's cool, but I just hope he gets his head on straight, because without Liz now, he's just not the same.
Well, what is the relationship with you and Elizabeth presently?
Well, right now, Elizabeth is my manager. It's strictly business, brother. There's no nibbling going on there, believe me.
No.
It's strictly business.
Hulk, she's a very attractive lady.
You're making me sweat, man.
Oh. There's been nothing, never even a kiss. Okay. Okay, I'll take your word for it. I'll take your word for it. Let's talk about the cage match. A lot of illegal stuff going on there.
Well, you know, the cage, you know, when you talk about wrestling, you get me all excited, but the steel cage match, was, you know, I mention what station or what it was on, or?
No.
No, was, okay, well, anyway, it was on late night prime time. Don't worry about what it was. We don't have to talk
about it. It was NBC, though.
That's right.
Because I don't want to miss you.
Okay, it was late night prime time, the highest ratings around, I can tell you that. But what happened was I was going around with a big boss man, beating him all over the country, and he kept popping off, and he's got this manager named Slick.
Yeah.
And once he jumped up in my face, dude, the WWF officials decided to end this thing once and for all. So they put a 20-foot high cage, 20 feet high, 20 feet long, all the way around the ring. No way in, no way out. And I took the boss man down to his knees, and I showed him the Hulkamania brand of justice.
Yeah.
If you watched it, you saw me suplex him 20 feet high off the top of the cage. Almost a career-ending move, but I came out on top.
That was scary, man, because you all came down from the cage.
Man.
I mean, just, you would think the fall would hurt somebody.
You just close your eyes.
Oh, okay. You think Big Boss Man will ever get shorts and wrestling gear, or will he always wrestle?
Well, that ugly body, dude, the way he looks, he's so fat and ugly, I don't think he'll ever show his body.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense. I read in the paper that this football player, Tony Mandridge, was going to fight Mike Tyson, possibly. Would you ever fight a boxer?
Well, I tell you what, I'd get it on with a boxer like Tyson if they wanted to, but if they wanted to make the fight fair, they better put a pair of handcuffs on me. You know, yeah. Tyson's got them gloves, you know, and I got all these other things, all other parts of the body to use. I can take him down, put him in my hammer lock, a wrist lock, a leg lock, and I tell you what, once I get on top, if he gets close enough to hit me, I just reach out and grab him.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, man. I just don't want him to have a flashback and think I'm Slick.
Boy, so what's next for you in the ring?
Well, I don't know. You know, I got the WWF title back, thank God.
Yeah.
And I'm ready for anything, you know. Basically, there's a lot of hard work. There's a lot of guys that want to take my spot. You ought to know how that is, man.
Yeah.
You just got to stay hot while you're hot. And this guy's real hot.
Stop it.
He's hot, man, I'm telling you. He's hot. I tell you, the thing with the movie, with No Holds Barred coming out, man, the thing with this thing is I yelled and screamed for 5 years to these kids to train, say your prayers, and eat your vitamins. And sometimes the kids wouldn't listen to their parents. Sometimes the kids wouldn't listen to their teachers or maybe somebody at church. But when the Huckster says, hey, little dude, if you don't eat your vegetables, I'm going to come in your house and body slam you. They listen, you know.
Yes, they do.
And so